In this lesson, I'm going to talk about an area where Brackets really shines, and that's editing CSS. The Quick Edit feature really differentiates Brackets from other code editors. I'm still working on my Brackets course project, and I'm in the pc.html file. The original project was started from the HTML5 boilerplate, so we have two CSS files, normalize and main. Normalize is the reset file, so we won't be touching that, but we will make our changes in main.css. Before we do anything, I want to change the font for this project, so I'm going to go to Google Fonts and grab the code to get Source Sans Pro, which I think looks very nice at a variety of weights. I have the link to this font in the lesson notes. I'm going to pick four weights, 300, 400, 600, and 900. I'm also going to get 400 italic. I can scroll down and grab the code to insert in the HTML head section. We want to insert it before the CSS so the fonts are available there. So if we're looking at the live preview, we can see nothing has changed yet, and that's because we need to update the CSS to say what elements should be using this font. I want everything to use this font, so I need to update the font family for the body tag. If we were using another code editor, we would have to add it directly to the main.css file. We would go to the file and put it right here in the authors section. Of course, we get great code hinting when typing the property we want to change. So if I type FO, we see all the font properties. And if I type another F, it will pick font family, which I want. The font name is Source Sans Pro. You can see in the live preview that the font has changed now. So that's good, but one of the neatest part of Brackets is the fact that you can edit your CSS without leaving your HTML. So let's try that method to update the main color of the text on the page. I'll go back to pc.html and put my cursor in the body tag. I want to target body again because I want all the text on this page to be this color. The quick edit shortcut is Command plus E, and this is one of the big shortcuts you'll want to remember if you're going to use this feature. You can get to Quick Edit from the Navigate menu, but the shortcut is much faster. As long as your cursor is inside of the tag when you hit Quick Edit, you'll bring up the Quick Edit screen inside of your HTML right underneath the tag. You can see we have three main parts to focus on here. This area on the right is showing us that there are three places in the CSS that target the body selector. It's showing us the selector first, then the file name and the line number. So we have two selectors from main and one from normalize. This area on the left is the actual code, and that's where we can edit the CSS. We can use all the normal editing features of Brackets to edit the code right here. First, however, notice that when I click on different selectors over on the right, the code on the left changes. The first selector is the one we want to modify, so we don't need to change it this time. So I want to add a new line to change the color of the text. I'll cursor down to the selector and then add the cursor to the next line with the shortcut Command plus Enter. Then I can set the color to 444. The third section of the Quick Edit pane is this top line where it's telling you what file you're in and what line number the selector starts on. In this case, we're starting with a previous comment, which Brackets include since it could often be relevant to your code. For this one, the comment isn't important since it's a section header. Also notice that there's a little circle next to the file name. That indicates the file hasn't been saved yet. We can actually save the CSS while in Quick Edit mode, so if I save it, you can see that the circle goes away. The other thing to note is that the file name is actually a link, and if you click on it, you'll be taken to the CSS file at that line. When I go back to the pc.html page, Quick Edit is still open and I'm still in the same spot. To close Quick Edit, I can just hit Escape. The next thing I want to do is make the header bigger, so I can go to the h1 tag and start Quick Edit. The two rules that target h1 are this first rule, which targets everything for the print reset, and the reset rule in normalize. Since I don't have an existing rule to add to, I need to create a new rule. If I click on the New Rule button, I'm given the choice of files, and I'll choose main.css. I'll add the font size by typing FOS, which gets me to that quickly. I'll change the size to 3.5m. I also want to update the weight of the header. It defaults to bold, but I want to specify the specific weight. I want 600. Let's look at where Brackets put this code. I'll click on the link to the CSS file. You can see that the new rules automatically get put at the very bottom of the page. that isn't necessarily where I want them. If we scroll up, we can see that there are a few sections like print styles after the author style section. I really want my new code to be in author styles. So what I like to do is create a comment at the bottom to specify that these are quick edit styles that should be moved. I'll copy a comment from before so I can keep the same style and edit it. Then I can move this style up to the author's style section. This is only an issue when you're creating new rules, so as time goes on, you'll need to move code less. It wouldn't be much of an issue on a larger project where your print style sheet would probably be in its own file and all your code is more modular. I'd like to shrink this image a little, so I can go to the image tag and quick edit and add a new rule. Then add width of 96 pixels. Now, this rule will apply to all images, which I obviously would not want if there's going to be any more images on the page. So I could add a class or make the selector more specific by adding the H1 before the image tag. So it only targets images and header ones. I want to make the font size of H2 2M. And the font weight of H3 300, so it's extra thin. I'm just going to write my next selector while still in quick edit mode since I know I need to create a new rule and they'll be next to each other anyway. Before I finish this lesson, I'd like to make a few more edits to the body selector to give the content on this page some breathing room and also give it a max width to keep it from growing too large on a big screen. Finally, this is unrelated to the CSS, but I don't need this analytics block of code and it keeps annoying me, so I'm going to delete it. I have more tricks and shortcuts to share about using Quick Edit, but I'll do that in the next lesson.